Once again, this is Dr. Hatem Al-Aishi from Dr. Hatem Al-Aishi Medical Center in Cairo, Egypt. How doctors diagnose a patient with an autoimmune rheumatic disease? If you have the autoimmune rheumatic disease called rheumatoid arthritis, for example, this means your diagnosis at the doctor's office actually happened in two steps. Step one, you were diagnosed as an autoimmune rheumatic disease in general. Step two, you were diagnosed as rheumatoid arthritis in particular. So step one is actually deciding your disease, whatever it is, belongs to the big family of the autoimmune rheumatic diseases. And step two, deciding that your disease is in particular the specific member of this family that is called rheumatoid arthritis. And you will notice in this figure that on the left side, you have only the family. You don't have any names of any members. But on the right side, you have the names of the members because we can sort you out as a single member of the family. Experts will usually do those two steps together at the same time with not much mental effort when they talk to you and also when they examine you and do investigations for you as needed. Getting you in the big family of the autoimmune rheumatic diseases requires general features, and assigning you a specific diagnosis requires fulfilling specific criteria for that particular disease. Now, I will tell you one piece of information about the general features and then one piece of information about fulfilling the specific criteria to complete this topic. The general features. Depending on the general features of how you describe your symptoms, the rheumatologist will decide that your problem belongs to the autoimmune rheumatic disease family and not to one of the other big families of joint disorders. Yes, rheumatology is about several different families of joint and musculoskeletal problems. We have overuse conditions, when you overuse your body and do a lot of exertion. We have endocrine diseases like hypothyroidism, it can cause joint pains. Degenerative conditions like osteoarthritis, aging of the joints. Autoimmune rheumatic diseases, our series. Infectious disease, microbes can cause arthritis. Metabolism problems like gout and pseudogout. Cancer, yes, cancer can present with an arthritis, it's not common, but it can happen. Functional problems like fibromyalgia, inherited problems like hypermobility. All those families of disorders can cause joint problems. And autoimmune rheumatic diseases is only one of those families. So when I listen to you, when I talk to you, and maybe when I examine you also, and maybe do investigations, I decide that you belong to the big family of autoimmune rheumatic diseases with those general features. Most of what I need comes from the history when I talk to you. Now, the second point, fulfilling specific criteria. At a time when the different members of the autoimmune rheumatic disease family share common features that make each one of them an autoimmune rheumatic disease, they differ in specific features that sort them out from each other. In medical terms, we call those specific features disease criteria. To diagnose psoriatic arthritis, for example, the patient needs to fulfill a minimum number of disease-related criteria, say 3 out of a defined set of 6. I'm just giving random figures. I'm not being specific about the diagnosis here because I'm relaying a concept of diagnosis and not how to diagnose psoriatic arthritis in particular now. To diagnose rheumatoid arthritis, the patient needs to fulfill a minimum number of different disease-related criteria, like 3 out of 6, so that I tell the patient you have rheumatoid arthritis, and so on. Who sets or defines those criteria requisites and defines the minimum requirements for making probable or definite diagnoses? It's rheumatologists. Through study groups, task forces, international conferences, and the process regularly gets refined as we get to know more and more over time. This is how you get the specific diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis or any one of his sister or brother diagnoses or cousin diagnoses in the autoimmune disease family. Now, the next video in this series is a very important one. It's about an entity we call undifferentiated arthritis. It's about having enough general features to belong to the big family of autoimmune rheumatic diseases, but not enough specific features to be assigned a specific rheumatic disease diagnosis. In other words, we know you are one of the members of the family, but we cannot tell which member you are.